In this video, I want to show you a simple way on how to get this type of 360 orbiting shot. Kind of. The concept we want to achieve is fairly straightforward. You have an object in the middle, and you want the camera to orbit that object at the same exact distance. Now, the challenges that we have to overcome in order to achieve this on a budget is to somehow rig a system that will keep the camera the same distance away from that object in the center, and it's going to allow us to swivel the camera in a complete 360 circle around that object. And that's where things kind of get tricky.
So to start off with, I'm going to try using a microphone stand and my Sony a6400 with this little zoom piece that comes with the recorders, which is perfect for going in a microphone stand. My thought process is, if I can keep the center right here, then I don't have to worry about the focus, and it will always be in frame according to the rotation of the microphone stand arm.
My first trial with the microphone stand was less than stellar, and it wasn't really what I was looking for. The camera was way too shaky. The tripod legs themselves needed sandbags or somebody to put their foot on it. The footage could be usable if I got enough tries doing it that way, but
I think I'm gonna try a C-stand because I have an actual tripod head that can plug into the end of the C-stand.
So my thinking is this. I have a travel tripod that allows me to remove the ball head camera mount part on the top, and I'm gonna take that and thread that into my C-stand because the type of C-stand that I own already comes with the types of threads that will fit into my ball head. Now all I have to do is put the camera at 90 degrees facing inwards toward the center, and voila, we've achieved a stabler way to move the camera in a 360 circle around a center piece. Now, I understand this isn't the most ideal way of doing this, but hey, we're getting creative and I'm using the resources that I have available to me to achieve this certain outcome. One thing I'd like to bring up is the fact that I'm using a 50 millimeter lens with a 1.8 aperture. Now, the reason why this is important is because of that focal length, I can compress down on the image. It's also the fastest lens that I own at f1.8. With those two things combined, I can now blur out all of the background at that f1.8, and I can also, with that compressed image, eliminate the pole at the bottom of the screen. Another thing that helped was to shoot at an upward angle, and I can also either scale in on the image to eliminate the pole at the bottom of the screen, or I could just add black bars to it and then call it cinematic. And I think going with the latter is more of the YouTube type of choice. Cinematic, cinematic, cinematic. Artificial black bars, black bars, black bars. Makes everything look better, 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 better. 1.8 aperture, aperture, aperture. I'm just like every other YouTuber saying cinematic, cinematic, cinematic. But guess what? It just looks better, okay? I know I'm cliche and using black bars and shooting at the fastest aperture, but you know what? I like the way it looks. Moving on. After setting it up, I knew it was gonna work, so I weighed it down with some weights. The next thing I moved on to was lights. And because I'm shooting in slow motion, you're going to need a lot of light in order for your shots to look great. The strongest light that I own is the Aperture 120D Mark II. That thing puts out a bunch of light. I also have the light dome on it. I finally landed on putting it directly behind me because I think that illuminated the glass well. But in hindsight, if I had the budget, I would have loved to have put the 120D with the light dome directly above my object and out of frame. This is if I would have had another C-stand with enough weight to support that. That way, my biggest light source wouldn't have been taking up a whole bunch of the frame as I orbit the object. As for the rest of the lights,
I have a normal like Home Depot looking light thingy, daylight here. I just threw up a couple other lights too, just to add more light. I have a Philips Hue going on in the background and my Dracast LED light.
I basically just took all of the rest of the lights that I own and tried to put them up in different spots. That way it added texture to that whole orbiting effect, meaning that objects that are closer to the camera are going to move slower than those that are farther away from the camera, giving that really cool juxtaposition of space as you orbit around an object. Now, when it came to this specific shot, I wasn't able to do the full 360 because I had to be standing on a step stool pouring the water into the glass. So potentially, if you wanted to do this kind of shot as a 360, you would need some sort of support that came from above and not from the ground. That way, the bar won't get obstructed by whatever your support structure is. That's the biggest hiccup in setting up the shot this way, but that's why I'm saying it's kind of a simple-ish way to do the 360 orbiting shot.
3, 2, 1, go.
In terms of the final product, I'm very happy with the results that we got. Hopefully, if you want to achieve a shot like this for any kind of project and you own a C-stand, I would highly encourage you to try it out because I had a lot of fun making this video and I think you will too. Until next time, my name's Javier Mercedes. I do video tech tutorials on this channel. You could hit the subscribe button if this is your first time here and you like my teaching style. If not, hey, I have some other videos that you could check out. And I hope you're out there living a life of abundance. Bye.